as Uganda joined the rest of the African continent to commemorate the Day of the African Child today, medical experts here in the country are calling on the government to ensure that children's health is addressed, especially because they are very much affected during their growth. Dr. Olive Kobosinje, the head of trauma unit at Makerere University School of Public Health, says that more children suffer from injuries that sometimes lead to permanent change. Let's take a look.
I want to remind ourselves of why the African Child Day is celebrated on the 16th of June every year.
The Day of the African Child is celebrated every year on June 16th. The theme this year is 30 years after adoption of the Charter, accelerate the implementation of Agenda 2040 for an African fit for children. During the celebrations in Uganda today at Makerere University School of Public Health, it was revealed in a report that unintentional injuries are prevalent and have claimed many lives of children below 5 years, while others suffer permanent physical and psychological trauma.
Many mothers are working, and in many places they cannot go with the child. So they either leave them with the maid or they delegate their siblings. And in that time, a lot goes on that puts the kids at risk. For example, if you delegate to a child who is 8 years old, they may not be able to give that care, the supervision that is actually required. And that's what one of the findings that showed was poor supervision.
Most people do not realize that our homes are built for grown-ups and that children have to somehow survive in an environment that is built for grown-ups. So every parent that has a child below the age of 5, especially those that are first-time parents, just get on your knees and experience your home from the perspective of a toddler or a very small child.
The experts have now called upon the government and all stakeholders to address the health challenges that affect children.
Making sure that the environment is built for children is the first thing, and is built for the most vulnerable, which means it is built for the smallest person in the home. And so move away things that a child might pull that would fall on them, move away things that a child might ram into, and make a home that is safe for a child under the age of 5. And then if you have to delegate supervision, make sure that the person's role is actually to supervise the child and not to cook, clean, and 10 other things in addition to the child.
According to research, the commonest injuries among children below 5 years are burns, falls, and cuts. They are attributed to children's physical development and risk-taking behaviors. Makerere University School of Public Health is implementing a project that will prevent unintentional damage among children below 5 years. Meanwhile, separate celebrations were also held at Golf Course Hotel in Kampala. During the celebrations, children aired out their concerns.
Another issue that was mentioned was about the street kids. These children, they don't have a way of survival outside there. Some get like an elder will tell you like, if you want me to give you somewhere to stay, you have to steal something. You have to bring something back. In most cases, if you take it to the issue of family, this kid will be like, you know what, go outside there and work and bring money. We eat, we survive. So if these people steal for surviving, when they are arrested, they are killed.
Did you know that violence has problems like death of children, diseases, unwanted pregnancies, and drop out of school, and many more? It is time for us to report these bad acts of violence to our parents, teachers, nurses, leaders, and police.
The UNICEF representative to Uganda expressed concern over government's move to close schools as a measure to curb the COVID-19 pandemic. She warned that it could be more devastating to the children.
Schools need to be a safer place for every child. And it is in our hands to make schools safer for every child. Schools are the kind of institutions that we can easily control compared to any other place. We can enforce the SOPs, the standards for protecting children, for making the schools safe. We need additional financial investment. We need a commitment from the teachers, and we need a commitment from the parents and for everyone to make school a safe place for children.
Story by Rachel Nachuala for the news.